At this point, we've seen that units of area and volume are just powers of units of length. But it turns out that not all area and volume units are like that. In fact, some units of area and some units of volume don't have any one-dimensional equivalents at all. They have no length equivalents. They don't have anything that we measure like one would measure on a ruler. Some units of area and volume, for instance, acres, hectares, and several others, don't have a one-dimensional equivalent. You do not have a one-dimensional version of these two-dimensional units. For volume, some common ones include liters and gallons. There are many, many, many others, including quite a lot of archaic ones, but those are some of the more common ones. Fortunately, when we convert these, we don't have to apply powers or exponents like we did with cubic inches or cubic centimeters. They will already be implied, and they'll already exist in the conversion unit itself. Another thing that makes this a little easier is that a cubic centimeter is exactly the same thing as a milliliter. You might see cubic centimeters abbreviated as cc in certain medical applications, or you might see it written with cm to the third power. These all mean the same thing. So for our first problem, a dosage for a certain liquid medicine is 15 cc's, or 15 cubic centimeters, and we want to convert this into fluid ounces. We begin, of course, with 15 cubic centimeters, and one thing we can use to our advantage is our ability to convert this into another unit. In this case, the easiest thing to do is convert into liters, convert that into gallons, then convert that back into fluid ounces. So we'll use a chain of conversion rates here. And the first one we'll use is, and in fact, you don't even need symbols for this, the first thing we'll do is replace cubic centimeters with milliliters. And so if I replace that with milliliters, well, we know that 1,000 milliliters is equal to 1 liter. And again, we can do this because a milliliter is a liter. We can just make that switch. You should also have a conversion sheet that tells you that 3.79 liters is 1 gallon. And from there, we just convert back down to fluid ounces. We know that 1 gallon is equal to 4 quarts. We also know that 1 quart is equal to 2 pints. Furthermore, we know that 1 pint is equal to 2 cups. And finally, we know that each cup is equal to 8 fluid ounces. These are all conversions that come off of a conversion sheet that you should have access to. And then from here on out, we just divide units out. Milliliters divide, liters divide, and so on and so forth. They should all be positioned oppositely because that will induce them to divide out. And then as we go, we can divide by 1,000. We can divide by 3.79. We multiply by 4, multiply by 2, multiply by 2, multiply by 8. And as we do this, we should arrive at our answer. We get that our answer is about 0.5066 fluid ounces, so about half of a fluid ounce. Our next example requires us to chain together several more units. The average American farm has 434 acres of land, and we want to convert this to hectares. Acres and hectares, as we've mentioned before, are both units that have no single-dimensional equivalent, but we can convert them into units that do. We know that we are beginning with 434 acres. We also know from what's provided us that a single acre is 43,560 square feet. Well, as it happens, acres are a U.S. customary unit, while hectares are a metric unit. And that means we have to find some way to bridge that gap between U.S. customary and metric. If you'll remember, the best way to do that is to use the conversion that 1 inch is exactly 2.54 centimeters. So we'll convert square feet into square inches. We know that 1 foot is equal to 12 inches. We also know that if we want to make this relevant to area, we will have to square all of these. 12 squared is 144. And we continue in this vein. We will now convert inches into centimeters for the same reason. And in the same manner, we square everything yet again. Here we get 6.4516. And now that we have square centimeters, we just need to convert that back into hectares, which means we need to begin by converting square centimeters into square meters. We know that 100 centimeters is 1 meter. And again, to get the matching set that we need, we just square everything. Here you will discover 100 squared is 10,000. Our last conversion is to convert that into hectares. And again, because hectares are a designated unit, there is no need to take powers here. So if you notice, for this unit, acres are already a designated area unit. There is no need for an exponent. And similarly for this unit, there's also no need for an exponent. And now the rest of the way, we multiply by 43,560, then by 144, then by 60.4516, we divide by 10,000 twice. If you do this correctly, you should ultimately end up with about 175.6
hectares.
And so we see that in order to convert designated units, we don't actually have to take powers. We only have to take powers when we're converting like units into area or volume units.